Hello and welcome to the first lesson in a brand new course to teach you all about how to master commands in Minecraft. My name is slicedlime and I'm here to guide you from novice to expert. In this first episode, we're going to start with the very basics of using commands in Minecraft. To begin with, make sure you're on the right version. We're on Java edition in this course and the details here will not work on the current version of the Bedrock edition. We're making this in Minecraft 1.19.2. But if you have a later version, that should also be okay, as long as there are no messages about this video being out of date. Let's get going! It's time to run our first command. To do that, you're going to open up chat by pressing T and then type in a forward slash. This is how the game knows that you're entering a command rather than a message to send to other players. Now, as you can see, what has happened is a list has appeared of commands I can run. This is called autocomplete. As you type commands, the game will help out by listing what things could come next. If you type something that is the start of a word in the list, you can then hit Tab to complete the word, which means that you don't have to type it all out. For our first command, let's type /say, followed by hello world. This simply makes us say a line in chat, which seems pretty useless right now, but we'll have some use for this command later. Another very useful command is /help. Just typing that alone will give you a full list of all the available commands and their syntax, which means what type of input the game expects for that command. A more useful way to use the help command is to use /help followed by the name of another command. That will show the syntax for only that command. Doing that for our say command, for instance, shows that the game expects the command to be followed by a message, which is exactly what we entered there before. Let's go through some terms that will be used throughout this series here. Syntax, like I just mentioned, is the expected format for a command. The syntax for a command is its name, followed by a number of inputs called arguments. Each argument is one logical unit specifying one thing, such as the name of a block, or a position in the world. To take the examples we've just seen, the say command expects one argument, which is a message. The help command has an optional argument, which is the name of another command. Now we want to access all commands, which is only available in worlds with cheats enabled or on a server where you have operator access. Usually, when starting a new project where you want to use commands, the best option is to start a creative mode world. This automatically switches on cheats, and you'll need to be in creative mode later anyway to use command blocks. If you're in a single player world where you don't have cheats enabled, don't worry. You can switch them on temporarily by pausing the game and hitting the Open to LAN button. Make sure you have Enable Cheats selected on the screen before you hit Start LAN World. And then you'll be able to use commands in this world until you close the world the next time. Our first truly useful command is going to be the give command. /help give tells us the command expects targets, then an item, then a count. The square brackets around the count indicate that it's an optional argument, so we can leave that out. Let's try it out. /give, /slicedlime, that's our target, in this case myself. Diamond. That's our item. That gives me a diamond. Very useful, I like diamonds. If you're trying this for yourself, I suggest you use your own nickname instead. While it would be nice of you to try to give me diamonds, the command only works for targets that exist within the game world we have open. So, if you're giving items to a friend on a multiplayer server, it will only work when they are online. If you're experimenting with commands, it's often useful to try variants of the same one over again. This can get tedious if you're typing in the same thing over and over, but luckily we don't need to do that. Minecraft remembers our previous entries, so while you have the chat open, press the up arrow to navigate to an earlier input. Then you can just modify that one for your experiment instead of starting over from scratch. Handy! Let's put that to the test. We can add in the count argument to our give command to get multiple items at once. And let's switch out the item. /give/lime, lime_wool. I can hit tab here to autocomplete the entire item, then 64. That gives me an entire stack of lime wool at once. Maybe you noticed something strange in the autocomplete list when I typed in the name of the items. It isn't showing me diamond or lime_wool. It's showing me Minecraft colon followed by the item names. This is what is called a namespace. We won't really need them for now, but let's just say that everything built into the game has a Minecraft colon prefix. Minecraft colon is also the default, so for built-in items we can conveniently leave that out, and it'll work exactly the same. One very useful thing that we can do with the give command is to give ourselves a command block. We'll be using command blocks in a wide variety of ways, so it's worth getting comfortable with them. /gib /slicedlime command_block gives me a command block. Now I can place that down, and as long as I'm in creative mode, I can interact with the block to open this user interface. We've got a few buttons here that we'll get back to later. The most important thing right now is the text input, which works just like the chat does. You don't need a slash at the beginning here, since everything in a command block is always a command, and you can immediately see that we get the autocomplete help here as well. Let's try our say command here. Say, hi there. Now we can click done. Nothing happened immediately because the command block also needs to be activated to perform the command. We can do that by powering the block with redstone. Let's take a button and place it on the block, which we can do by sneaking while placing the button. Click the button and now we'll see the message in the chat. The @ sign is simply the name of the command block. This is a pretty useful way to check that your command actually gets run. Sometimes when making command contraptions, what you think is a problem with your command is simply that it didn't even run in the first place. Replacing the command with a say command is a good way to find that out. Before we continue, I'd like to ask that you take a brief moment and click not only the in-game button, but also the like button. That helps YouTube show the video to more people, so I do appreciate it. Thank you. There's also a second way to activate a command block that doesn't involve a redstone signal. If we open the interface again by interacting with the block, you can see the rightmost button says needs redstone. If we click that, it changes to always active. This means the command block will activate without needing a redstone signal, so as soon as we hit the done button now, the message appears in chat. This is sometimes useful when you just want to run a command once to test it out, but remember that the command block is now in always active mode, so sending it a redstone signal no longer does anything. If you want to reactivate such a block, turn it off and then on again, so to speak. Of course, we can also use the give command inside a command block, just like we could from the chat input. Let's make this command block give me a TNT block by setting the command to give slicedlime TNT. We'll add a button to it and now I've got myself a magic TNT dispenser. Very handy, nothing could possibly go wrong with this. And that's all for this first lesson. Today we learned our first commands, the say, help and give commands. Make sure to download the companion map and go through the exercises there to get some hands-on practice with using commands.